With me from markets.com this afternoon, I've got Neil Wilson. Neil, great to see you. Good afternoon.
Thanks, Andrew. Good to see you.
A bit of a slowdown in quarterly sales growth for Morrisons today, Neil, but still some fairly strong numbers here.
Yeah, I mean, it was a bit of a slowdown from the blowout second quarter, which was obviously impacted by the good summer and the World Cup. But it's still very strong like-for-like group sales growth of in excess of 5%. I think it's a really, really good story that's been going at Morrisons for a long time now under Dave Potts. And if you look at the wholesale growth in particular, that's really where we see real strength. But arguably in the retail, the core supermarket area, like-for-like growth of 1.3% is the softest in quite a long time, and maybe it's just offering some concerns that, you know, faced with such a competitive supermarket sector. It's always competitive, but uniquely competitive these days with the advance of the discounters. Maybe Morrisons is just seeing that growth slow down a wee bit.
You reckon to some degree the wholesale division, that's been underappreciated by the market?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, it's a really capital light sort of growth lever for Morrisons. It's very, it can deliver growth quite quickly and quite cheaply. And I think it's also got these tie-ups with Amazon. It's got the forecourts. It's got, the wholesale, of course, with McCall's convenience stores. It's a big area. And I think it's, if you look at Tesco, their deal with Booker was off. Was a sort of factor in that. It's this idea that if you tie up the end to end with the wholesale as well as the retail, then you're in a better place. I think Morrisons is already there, and it didn't cost it £3.9 billion like it did for Tesco.
Some numbers today, Neil, from Associated British Foods. Primark, it seems, one of the saviours.
Yeah, I mean, Primark always does well. It's like-for-like growth in UK up a decent number. Headline growth overall was quite good. Overall, like-for-like, there was down 2%. That's due to some problems in Northern Europe. I think they blamed the weather, which everyone always does in retail. So not so sure about that, but certainly it was very hot, and maybe people were put off buying some of the sort of autumn clothes that they would normally go for at that time of year. Primark remains very solid. Profit margins improved a lot, and that's really encouraging for them. But then elsewhere, sugar is the big weight on the stock and the profits at the moment, the sugar division, just because sugar prices are low. But, sugar prices could bounce back. So I think it's a case that ABF is sort of managing its ship quite well. And in grocery as well, it's doing pretty well.
Just a quick word before I let you go, Neil. William Hill, profit warning, saw shares nosedive this morning.
Yeah, shares were off quite heavily. They've come back a bit since, though. I think, the profit warning, £20 million lower in 2018, £25 million lower in 2019. It is obviously, that these things do affect the share price, but I'd just be looking at that US growth story, where it's got an opportunity like nothing else really to unlock an amazingly large market, and that's operated for years just outside regulation. It's got a chance to get in there, and it's already got operations in Nevada that do very well, and it's got the sort of first mover advantage in the US, and I think it's probably it's in a not too bad a spot, really.
That's great. Many thanks, Neil.
Thanks, Andrew.